from different types of silk moth, we are getting different types of silk. For example, mulberry silk, tasa silk, airy silk, and muga silk. Let us discuss their uses. Mulberry silks are very soft and shiny, hence they are used for making pillow covers and curtains. Whereas tasa silk are yellow and brown in color, so they are used for making saris. Airy silk are strong and have thermal properties which can keep us warm. Hence, they are used along with wool for making winter clothes. And muga silks, they are durable and glossy. Hence, they are also used for making silk saris, which are generally found in Assam. Now, in this figure, you can see the clothes made up of mulberry silk, tasar silk, airy shawl, and muga silk. Now, the next topic is life history of the silk moth. This is the most important part of this chapter. As for obtaining silk, silk worms are reared on large scale. A female silk moth gives about hundreds of eggs on a mulberry leaf. Here we can see the first figure shows the eggs laid by the silk moth. And these eggs are then hatched for larva by keeping them under right temperature and humidity, which is done in the sericulture or in the silk farm. And this larva that we can see in the second figure in white color are also known as caterpillars or silkworm. Now the next stage in their life is pupa. Now, before coming to pupa, let us discuss that this silkworm or the caterpillars, they are generally fed on mulberry leaves. They eat those mulberry leaves, and after 20 to 25 days after eating, they grow up in size and then they stop eating, and now they are ready to enter into the next stage, that is known as pupa. And to enter into that stage, it swings its head from side to side in form of the figure of 8, the 8 of that maths. And while swinging the head, it secretes fiber made up of protein which hardens on exposure to air and becomes silk fiber. Means that protein, the fiber that is secreted by caterpillar, when it comes in contact with the air, it becomes very hard. And this fiber is actually the silk fiber. Soon, it completely covers itself by the silk fibers and turns into pupa, and this covering is known as cocoon. In this figure, we can see a caterpillar feeding on the mulberry leaves. In next figure, we will see the cocoon that is made by the fibers, which is white in color, and this silk moth are now known as pupa, which remains inside this cover, that is cocoon. And so the further development of moth continues inside the cocoon. It keeps on growing, and when this pupa develops fully to form an adult silk moth, then the cocoon splits and the silk moth comes out, and then this adult silk moth again lays eggs. And in this way, and this is the way the silk moth lives a life, and this is the whole life history of a silk moth. Now there is a diagram which shows the complete life history of silk moth.